Everything you see here is something that started in our own living room. When we started this company, we didn't have anyone to push us. We only had each other. We didn't have any mentors or anyone to actually tell us how to do this the proper way. So we made many mistakes and we just figured a lot of lessons on the way and on the road to getting to this point. We didn't have anyone else but each other to push each other and to learn from. So it was pretty difficult because we wanted to quit so many times. We had really hard time seeing in the first 2 years, is this even viable? Is this even something that we can get success with? But we were so determined to get to that point where we actually could provide ourselves with a salary and we could also like quit our normal job and just move out and then focus completely on this. It's been really difficult, but now we are here and now we got to a much happier place. We got our freedom. We can basically organize the whole company, take vacations and holidays whenever we feel like it. And this is something that has been really, really awesome getting to this point. Economics has been pretty difficult because sometimes the customer doesn't always pay at the right time. Some customers maybe go bankrupt, so we lose capital in this way. We are now at the position where we are three partners and one of the partners can always be somewhere else. We don't have the capacity yet that we can go all three partners to have a vacation. The products we are producing in here, it's called microgreens. It's basically the stage after a sprout. So this is the stage where the plant doesn't have necessarily the true leaf, and the true leaf is the leaf that comes that has the true identity of the plant after the first two leaves. And the first two leaves, when you have it like this, it's called a microgreen. And we are growing a lot of different varieties of microgreens. We are growing live microgreens, but we're also cutting them and serving them to our customers in a cutted way. But we have been doing this for 5 years and we learned so many things during this road. This is something that we basically are able to do all around the world. Growing microgreens is kind of like learning to play chess. A typical chess player has like thinking 2 to 3 moves ahead, and the really good players are predicting the next 5 to 6 moves, while the grandmasters and the masters are predicting the next 12 to 13 moves. And it's basically the same with growing microgreens, because yeah, you can easily learn how to grow a tray like this and you can easily learn how to make this work. But to know exactly when to take the right moves at the right time, that's what requires the mastering of this skill. So it's like kind of an art learning how to make a system like growing microgreens work, because everyone can grow microgreens and they can also sell them. But I haven't seen that many companies reach this size and get to this point, because this is what requires the mastering of the art of growing microgreens. It's really difficult getting to this point because you have to know so many industries and you have to have so much inside knowledge about how the different industries work. How does the supermarket chains work? How does the retail market work, so you can scale your production in the right way and make it efficient and make it as profitable as possible? Well, this is something that we have found a really good way of getting to that point of knowing how to make the certain moves in the certain and right time. Because as you can see here, we are not growing all of these things for fun. We are actually selling everything we are growing. I think 2 or 3% of all the trays that you see in here will be thrown out. That's basically it. And we are not even throwing them out. We are using them for something else as well. But all you see inside this production is basically going to be sold within the next week or two. And that's the beautiful thing about microgreens. It's something that you can grow fast and you can sell it fast as well. And you have a high profitability on your trays if you know how to sell them to the right customers and you know which customers to sell them to. The churn is basically the rate of customers leaving you. And the rate of customers leaving us is really low. The average lifetime value per customer is really high and the average acquisition cost of our customers are really low. And this is something that we have been specializing in for such a long time now, and we know exactly what to focus on when starting a new business like this. We are helping other people start their own business as well and make it profitable, because a lot of people have a microgreen production, but it's a very low percentage of the people that have a microgreen production that actually makes it a profitable business that they can make a full-time salary on. This is what we have done. And if you want to start your own farm and start your own microgreen production, if you want to start a vertical farm like this, it's like, you know, you want to learn how to play piano. Do you want to learn from someone who just spent 20 hours learning to play a song? Or do you want to learn from someone who's already playing a symphony at a concert? This is what we are doing. And get in contact with us, because if you want to be among the high achievers inside a microgreen community, then you should definitely get in contact with us, because we are going to help you scale your farm into something that's very profitable. I want to show you something else that we're doing, because in the back of this production, we are actually also growing mushrooms. So let's go over there. Welcome to the back of the production. As you can see here, we have 7 containers that we are growing mushrooms in. So what I want to tell you as well is that if you want to start something like this up, it's really important that you choose some partners that have already done this, because this can save you at least 2 years of experience. So maybe you're gonna pay something to get the knowledge, but that's gonna save you so much time. And if you already have a job, you can save up some money, and then you can basically skip the hardest part of figuring this out. In here we have the container, one of the containers where we are growing oyster mushrooms. So you can come in and see. And this is basically oyster mushrooms that are growing inside of our growing bags. And you can see here, we're getting some really good growth inside of this. I want to tell you that, of course, you can get a lot of free content on YouTube. But if you think that everyone is just telling you their secrets and sharing everything, how everything is made, that is not how it's working. Of course, we want to show you what we're doing, but it just took us 5 years to get to this point. And as you can see here, we are getting some really, really good growth and really efficient growth on these mushroom bags. And yeah, it's really difficult getting to this point. But of course, we love to show you what we're doing, because we want to inspire other people, and we want to inspire you to see the possibilities of what is even possible growing a vertical farm like this. We're not sharing all of our secrets, but we are showing you what is possible. If you want to learn what we're doing, how we're doing it, and just basically partnering up with us in knowledge and becoming part of our community, then you should get in contact with us, because we are ready to help you guys scale your own farm and do it in a profitable way. So the last thing I want to ask you is a small favor. I want to spread the word of the vertical farming and spread the love of vertical farming. So if you would do us a favor, because this would be very important for us, go to our Instagram page, find us on Instagram, it's called Vertical Greens. Go to the link in the description where you can sign up on the email list. And also like the video, subscribe to our channel, and hit that notification bell, because that would be very awesome if you would do that. I hope that you got some value in this video, and I hope that we can work together in the future. Let us know if there's anything that we can help you with. I will see you in the next video.